This is my... It's not really Jacob's ladder. It's more of a... two bits of wire, giving a bit of a spark gap. It's quite nice, but it doesn't go out and use them. It's just a few amps. Keeping at 15 volts. It can go a little bit more, though. Particular transistor on here can take up 5 amps at the base, but it won't take anything else after that. Not for over a second or two, anyway. They're dead because I tried to run it a little bit over. A little bit over 5 amps for longer than a second or two, just to see what would happen. And, well, the data sheet said that 5 amps was the absolute maximum, and I just had to push it. But I do like it, it sort of like cleans the air, which is it's quite nice. At least it smells nice, but from what I've understood on a couple of videos that I've watched about doing this sort of thing. When they talk about, oh, you can smell the ozone, if that's what it is when you smell the freshness, they say it like it's a bad thing. Now, I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing, or maybe somebody could let me know. Because I just love it, I love the smell of it. Have you seen what I've done with it? Look, if it goes up a bit too high, it loses. If it doesn't start from the bottom, it sparks across at the top. My power supply takes a good few minutes of running this before it allows me to turn up a little bit more. It's a cheap 10 amp supply, but it's pretty good actually, just by one accident, and the supply on top is just running that little cooling fan. I've taken off the diode off the transistor and I've just put an LED there because, well, I can never tell sometimes when it fails a bit whether it's the diode or not, so. And the LED in my other circuit that I got, my big cycle, that works really well. It's the first thing to go. I did try putting a little resistor on the LED on the slayer, on the cycle, but my chip blew, and I just turned the amperature a bit too much, so I do prefer the LEDs. One, it gives a nice indicator. And to the work, they blow quicker, so it protects the transistor. The flyback coil from the back of the TV, you can't really see that well, but I'll turn this off in a second. It's the noise. If I can turn it up a little bit more, actually. So you can just see where the there we are with the amperage. I'll turn it all the way up. There you go, so I'm allowing it to pull 4.6 amps. I'm going to just see if I can just tweak it a little bit more. 4.7. I don't want to take it really past 4.8 because that's really fast pushing it. I'm going to have to back it up a little bit actually, so I can use the sine control to turn it up a little bit. I'm just going to back that down. And then just take a little tiny bit more of the coarse control. There we go, now I can use the fine control to take it to 4.8. I'm not going to go any higher than that because I don't want to kill the chip. And it does every time I go to 5 amps, just a little bit over. It kills the chips and it's just not worth it. So. That's 4-7. That's 4-8. I'm just gonna back it up again now. Just to in actual fact, I'm gonna keep it current limited at 4-7. There we go. Now I'm just gonna back up the voltage. It'll make more noise, but it'll go to the top a bit more. There we go. I must admit, I do like it when it goes up the ladder. Well, put the two bits of metal and sparks across the top. I wonder if we're going to continue to do that. I haven't got a capacitor on this circuit. I've been looking into building one, or a couple or two, depends how many I need, like Leyden jar type capacitors. So anyway, I think that's enough for that.